Hey guys, I want to show you a fascinating device that combines the most beloved features of single board computers, microservers, Linux, Docker, and more, all rolled into one neat package. A device that debuted at the end of the last year and is gaining popularity among us. It's hashtagged as single board server. Do you already know which computer I'm talking about? Say hello to ZimaBoard. This tiny but mighty computer may be small in size, but its capabilities and ambitions are anything but small. One disclaimer at the start, I'm not getting paid nor am I receiving any other form of compensation for doing this review. But guys and girls from the ZimaBoard company were kind enough to provide me this device so I could do this hands-on review. So, thank you. Moving on. Okay, let's start at the beginning of my journey. The delivery from the Zima company was super fast. It took less than a week to arrive at my doorstep. Considering it traveled across half the world, it's 20 points to Gryffindor. I mean, ZimaBoard company. Okay, from the doorstep to my desk. Let's unbox this baby. You see, it arrived in this nice, branded, undamaged box. You can see the company logo. Right off the bat, they are telling us that this is intended to be used as a home server, just slightly larger than the Raspberry Pi 4 or Orange Pi 5. It measures a mere 21 by 16 by 6 centimeters, but don't let the size fool you. It's brimming with features that promise to make your journey thrilling and satisfying. And you can see which version of the board I have in my hands. It's the 432 kit. More on that later. Okay, let's begin this journey together. Opening. Nice. World's first hackable single board server. Well, I still need to figure out what they meant by first hackable server, but I'll let that one pass for now. The message here is clear. It's a single board server, and we will have fun with it. At the back, you see some of the key features of this board. Let's get it all out. We've got a power adapter here with all the wall socket types and the server itself. User manual. Okay, let me put this aside, that's for noobs. Computer itself. And what do we have here? Oh yeah, that's the SATA cable. Nothing else here. And yay, stickers! And the grand finale. Oh yeah, that's a beautiful piece of hardware. Ethernet ports, USB ports, mini DP and power connector. And this is interesting. PCI Express at the side. SATA connectors at the front. I really like the sleek design of this thing. You can place it anywhere in your house or office and it will look great. Plus, you don't need to bother with buying or building a case for this. Not to mention it's metal, so the casing will work as a heatsink, that's for sure. Really, really neat. Now, if you're a regular here, you know that I mainly delve into ARM-based devices similar to at the same time loved and hated Raspberry Pi. But today we are treading on a little bit different path. This ZimaBoard is not an ARM device. It's built on the Intel x86 64-bit architecture, which is the same architecture used in the most desktops and laptops. This broadens its compatibility with various software and adds a whole new dimension to what a single board computer can do. It has its own benefits and drawbacks alike. So, in a way, it's a departure from my usual reviews, but a truly exciting one. Stay tuned. Powered by the Intel Celeron Apollo Lake processor, the ZimaBoard 432 features 4 cores with a 1.1 GHz base frequency, turbo boosting up to 2.2 GHz. You might say that it's lower base frequency compared to today's ARM devices, like Orange Pi running on ROG chips SoCs. And you would be correct, but it's not as simple as that. I don't want to overwhelm you with the technical details, but you should know it has to do with different instruction sets architectures, contributing to Intel processors being more powerful, but at the cost of higher price and power consumption. So it wouldn't be wise to compare these devices only by the base frequency of their CPU. Better check the snappiness of the whole system. And as an addition to that, Turbo Boost is a technology developed by Intel that enables a processor to exceed its base operating frequency when the operating system requests the highest performance state of the processor. In simpler terms, Turbo Boost allows a CPU to run faster than its base clock speed when only a few cores are being used during a heavy workload or a demanding task. This technology is based on the principle that not all CPU cores are utilized for every process. However, it's important to note that Turbo Boost is managed by the CPU itself, and it only engages when the CPU is operating below power, current, and temperature specifications limits. Simply put, you don't have control over it. ZimaBoard graphics performance is boosted by the Intel HD Graphics 500, operating at 200 MHz base frequency and a burst of 700 MHz. Well, yeah, I can't say that this is a very powerful graphics card, but it's enough for driving a 4K display at 60Hz via this mini display port. To be fair, this is the place where this board tramples the competition. If you ever have the need, you can slap a graphics card into this PCI Express slot. I mean real graphics card like GeForce 1070. You only need an external power source. But I'm getting ahead of myself. This is supposed to be a home server, not a gaming machine. Let's shift our gaze to an aspect that significantly affects the performance of any computer, the RAM. The ZimaBoard 432 boasts a solid 4GB of RAM, but that's not all. The ZimaBoard lineup offers versions to suit different needs and budgets. For instance, the entry-level ZimaBoard 216 features 2GB of RAM and 16GB of onboard eMMC storage, making it a more affordable yet capable option. If you're looking for more muscle, the top tier ZimaBoard 832 has 8GB of RAM and whopping 32GB of eMMC storage. No matter your needs, there's a ZimaBoard version tailored to your needs. It's all about finding the balance for your unique needs. As you might have noticed, the three numbers behind the ZimaBoard name specify the size of RAM and eMMC onboard storage space. I have the 432 version available to me, but what you are about to see will also apply to other ZimaBoards. Connectivity is where this device really shines. From dual SATA 6.0 Gbps ports, 2 Gigabit Ethernet LAN ports, dual USB 3 ports, and even a PCI Express 2.0. ZimaBoard offers several expansion options. To give you a taste of it, data hoarders can expand it to a massive 36TB disk space. Don't know what you would do with that, but you can. And that's the point. Compared to alternatives like Orange Pi or Raspberry Pi, one thing that is missing here are the GPIO pins. The device is not meant for projects needing them. But hey, it's presented as a home server, not a general purpose single board computer. This is a pure server, and it's not pretending otherwise. And honestly, I like that. Do one thing and do it well. This is not a catch-all party. But what really sets ZimaBoard apart from other SBCs like Raspberry Pi or Orange Pi is its Intel 64-bit architecture. While Raspberry Pi uses ARM, an architecture commonly found in smartphones and tablets, x86-64 is what you'll find in most desktop PCs and laptops. This difference enables ZimaBoard to run a wider variety of software, including some that are not available or require complicated workarounds on ARM devices. What do I have in mind? For example, Proxmox. If you've never heard of Proxmox, it's an open source server management platform that allows you to deploy and manage virtual machines and containers. More on that later. But for those who know, yeah, you can run Proxmox cluster on these devices. Let's see the ZimaBoard 432 in action. It comes pre-installed with Debian-based Linux and Casa OS, an open source home server system based on Docker. Docker, for those unfamiliar, is a platform that packages software into standardized units called containers. Each container is a standalone software package, including everything needed to run it. Code, runtime, system tools, system libraries, settings, and so on. This means you can run a variety of programs right on the device at your home. Useful things like Pi-hole, a network-wide ad blocker, Plex, an application to organize and stream your favorite movies or shows inside and outside of your home.
WordPress, allowing you to host your own website, and Portainer, a Docker container management tool. With the ZimaBoard, you can customize your home server ecosystem to your heart's liking. Let's take a look at all the predefined apps you can install and use with a simple mouse click. There's just too many, and there's more. You can simply import any Docker CLI or Docker Compose definition right into this, and you can run anything you want if it's Linux or Docker compatible. It's a fully featured Linux that this thing is running. But we are just getting started with what ZimaBoard can run. Picture Nextcloud, an open source suite that lets you manage and store data akin to Google Drive or iCloud, but hosted by none other than yourself. With ZimaBoard's impressive expandability, you can attach to it up to 36 terabytes of disk space using these two SATA ports. You can create a massive personal cloud storage system. And the best part? Nextcloud boasts with cross-platform compatibility with client apps available for all major operating systems, including Windows, macOS, Linux, Android, and iOS, ensuring that you can access and manage your personal cloud anytime, anywhere, and from any device. Not to mention all the famous plugins of Nextcloud itself. So you get me. You can run your own iCloud for free with this tiny little device. Or imagine a world where online privacy isn't just a luxury. That's what WireGuard VPN on ZimaBoard can offer. It's a cutting-edge VPN protocol that's popular for its speed, simplicity, and state-of-the-art cryptography. And for developers, ZimaBoard is your playground. Whether it's setting up a personal server like Git for version control, or running web servers such as Apache or Nginx, you have full flexibility. And speaking of flexibility, you can also host a Minecraft server for those relaxing gaming sessions with friends, or run Foundry VTT for immersive tabletop RPG experiences. Sky's the limit. And let's not forget the thriving world of home automation. With Home Assistant on ZimaBoard, you can create a smart home ecosystem that's entirely under your control. And for those of you stepping into the Docker realm, Portainer simplifies container management, making your journey smoother. But hold on, there's more to the ZimaBoard magic. As I've mentioned before, for those of you who are into server clustering, you're in for a treat. With multiple ZimaBoards, you can set up a power-efficient and robust server cluster using Proxmox. Intrigued? You should be. One of our fellow tech YouTubers has done a fantastic job detailing the process in his video. You'll find the link to it right up here. And I've also included it in the description below. It's a must-watch for anyone keen on diving deeper into the realms of home server clustering. And last but not least, you can turn this board into an almost enterprise-grade firewall with pfSense. It's 2023, so if you're sick of those big beefy routers or firewalls, you can build a power-efficient gigabit one with ZimaBoard. I've made a few tests, and I'll bet you its power consumption will be under 5 watts, and that's something worth mentioning. In essence, the ZimaBoard 432 empowers you to run some of the most popular, innovative, and practical applications in today's home lab world, transforming your home into a highly customized, powerful tech hub. When pitted against other SBCs, ZimaBoard OS compatibility is evident. Besides its pre-installed Linux-based Casa OS, it supports Windows, OpenWRT, pfSense, Android, and LibreElec, among others. And we shouldn't skip over the Casa OS that is developed for ZimaBoard. This Casa OS is basically nice web GUI for administrating the Docker environment running on this device. Under the hood, it's Debian Linux, but I was impressed by how user-friendly it was for new users. Of course, it seems just like a nice interface for everything you can do in the terminal. But hey, that's the whole point, making working with this device and Docker itself a breeze for new users. You don't have to use it, but it's nice to have the possibility to manage your stuff via a nice clean web page. It's pre-installed on the device when you buy it, and accessing it is as simple as writing casaos.local into your browser, on your PC or notebook, and boom, here's the interface. Now let's talk about something that is often overlooked but extremely important when it comes to SBCs, power consumption. The ZimaBoard 432 is a testament to energy efficiency, consuming a mere 3.4 watts when idling. And when I stress test the CPU, it goes up to 7 watts. This is astounding when you consider that this is not ARM-based. It's ideal for those seeking a powerful yet power-friendly computing solution. As you can see, the ZimaBoard 432 offers impressive performance without skyrocketing your electricity bills. For just $159, the ZimaBoard 432 packs an impressive punch in a surprisingly compact shell. And you can even expand its capabilities by throwing some accessories into the shopping cart. Just check out the manufacturer's website.
If this board made an impression on you, let me know in the comments. I'm more than willing to do more tips and tutorials for you about this great device. I really am looking forward to testing it thoroughly. All things considered, the ZimaBoard offers a compelling package for makers, hobbyists, and professionals alike. Its 64-bit Intel architecture, impressive connectivity options, and the Docker capabilities make it an exceptional tool for multitude of home projects. If this video was helpful to you, remember to give it a thumbs up and subscribe to my channel for more in-depth reviews. Until next time, bye!